We've just bought a 1965 Dodge A100 Sportsman. We think our best chance to sell it on at a profit is by keeping the vintage patinated exterior as we transform it into a modern day surf wagon.
I'm going to remove the entire front suspension, and it all comes apart in just a handful of nuts and bolts. Now, this type of suspension design is literally hundreds of years old. In fact, it can trace its heritage back to the days of the old horse and cart. And it's really, really simple, but absolutely brilliant. It basically works with two leaf springs and a fixed beam axle in the middle. But I feel like I'm chasing a really modern market for our van. So I'm going to ditch this old-style system and I'm going to go for a state-of-the-art airbag system. Now, the first calculation is to work out what wheels and tyres I want to use. Now, if I look at the ones that are already on the van, visually, they just look too big. Now, the handy thing about tyres is it gives you the size on the side, here. And in our case, 235, 75, 15. And what that relates to is 235 is the width, 235 millimetres. The 75 is a measurement of the sidewall, here, 75% of 235, and the 15 is the rim size. I quite like the rim size, maybe go an inch bigger, but it's this tyre wall that's just too big. So I'm going to reduce it. I'm going to stay with 235 width, but I'm going to drop it down to 50% with a larger 16-inch rim. So the rim will be around about here. The tyre will be around about here. 225, 55, 16. That's going to look really, really cool within the wheel arch, plus give us a little bit of space to lower the van. I'm going to start with this, an off-the-shelf subframe Micah's sourced for me, along with other suspension components. The Dodge A100 chassis is made up of two parallel frame rails that run the length of the van. These rails are what I'll attach the new suspension to. My plan is to install a modern, independent suspension that includes airbags for adjusting the ride height. This will not only make our A100 surf wagon look cool, but will also allow it to cover a lot of different kinds of terrain without getting bogged down. And by the time it's finished, I'll be sitting here, driving the car, Mike will be sitting here, and he'll be sad because he's not driving. Now, the cross member needs to fit between these two chassis rails, and the distance is 840 millimetres. I'm trimming the flanges down so the part is the exact right length, 840 millimetres or 33 inches across, and smoothing out the rough edges. Right, moment of truth. This should fit. That's perfect. It fits between the chassis wheels really well. Now, the second critical measurement is to whereabouts it goes in the chassis wheels. I need it to be dead centre so that the wheel fits exactly in the middle of the arch. And what's great about this van is that kind of does it for me because of this little bump stop bracket. This is the centre of the wheel arch, so I'm going to use this as my reference point for where I'm going to weld this. Problem is, at the moment, it's in the way. I'm going to cut it out. In the old suspension, bump stops kept the springs from compressing too much or bottoming out and damaging the frame. The new independent suspension doesn't require bump stops, and I need the room for our new subframe. I've cut the bump stops off, but I've deliberately left the back portion of the bracket in place, and there's a reason for that. It just so happens that the inside dimension of my new crossmember is exactly the same size. It guarantees that the new crossmember is exactly in the middle of the arch. Saves me a load of messing around. I'm attaching the lower wishbones to the subframe. The spindles come next. I can already tell from here, it's way too high. Drop it. Positioning the subframe properly is essential for the wheels to fit within the arches. I'm using a cardboard cutout to help me determine the final location for the van's wheels. Perfect. I'm tacking the new subframe in place, but it needs some beefing up. So I'm cutting extra pieces of reinforcing material called gussets out of steel box section. This gusset piece is really important. Now, without it, we're relying on that tiny little bit of weld in the corner to hold this whole cross member. But with it, we get to weld down the whole length of the chassis, join these two bits together, it all becomes one big strong unit. Right, that's the lower cross member done. That holds the bottom wishbones. I now need to crack on with the top part to hold the top wishbones. The upper wishbones will be attached within the wheel arch, so I need to measure them to figure out how big a hole to cut. The upper wishbones connect to an off-the-shelf bracket. Measuring is critical when positioning this part. Looks like the bracket is a little bit too long to allow the wheel to fit within the arch. Means I'm going to have to trim it down. I'm joining the bracket to the van's frame using a continuous bead of weld for the strongest possible connection. Then, installing the upper wishbone. Marvellous. Now, this is the fancy bit, the airbags. Now that the suspension's fully assembled, you can clearly see how the airbag system works. This bag here, via a switch in the cockpit, either fills with air, lowering the wishbones, raising the height of the body, or it decreases, emptying the air, raising the wishbones and lowering the height of the body. And that is fully adjustable at the flick of a switch within the cockpit. Cool stuff. When Mike brought this van into the workshop, it was fitted with a rubbish slant six engine that leaked oil and coughed out loads of smoke. Now, I've tried to save it because it's part of the van's history, but ultimately, it was a lost cause. Now, remember, back in the 60s, if I'd have walked into the showroom to buy a van like this, I'd have had the choice between a slant six or a V8. And given that choice, I'd choose V8 every day of the week. Now, putting it in the van is a two-man job.
Yeah, come on, son, this ain't gonna fit itself. Look at that, that looks nice, that engine.
Yeah, good.
Is that good?
Yeah, lower that down.
Nice and slowly?
Yes, please.
RA100 is a cab over design. This means that the engine is placed beneath the cab instead of under the bonnet. The layout was popular in the 60s and 70s when there were length limits on vehicles, as it meant more space for passengers and gear.
No, it's not bad at all, is it?
Right, go and get the gearbox.
One gearbox as ordered, sir.
Nice one. I can pretty much take it from here. Give you a shout if I need you.
Yeah, no worries. Always on the end of the phone if you need me.
Thank you.
I'm notching the cross member to make room for the transmission. Now, here's a little problem. All the cutting has weakened the cross member, so I need to reinforce it with pieces of plate steel. I'm welding the steel plates to the cross member. They will close the opening and add strength. Gussets beef up the gearbox mount.
Now I'm just going to test fit the gearbox. Make sure that it clears the floor, clears the cross member with plenty of space. Yeah, there's good space around the floor, good clearance around the cross member, and the gearbox mount lines up really nicely. Yeah, I'm really pleased with that.
Click here to subscribe.